Hi, teachers and parents. Chelsea Stout here with your Monday Minute. Today I'm going to explain how to implement the use of a visual schedule. Visual schedules are used typically for students that need consistency and structure to help them navigate their day successfully. First off, I would recommend that every teacher and parent have a basic schedule visible that outlines their day in the classroom or the home. This is a basic support that most people need to thrive. For your students that are able to navigate their day using general support similar to their same age peers, you may try just having a written agenda or a schedule on the board or refrigerator for all of your students or family members to use. Parents, in the home, this could be a checklist or a schedule for each day that your child follows. Or if you prefer a looser format, a calendar can serve the same purpose of alerting family members of the daily, weekly, and monthly events occurring in the home. However, for our students that require an increased level of support, structure, or consistency, we may need to consider a schedule that is a bit more specific and individualized to the needs of your child. This is where a visual schedule comes in handy. Visual schedules come in many formats, and you can often find free templates online, or sometimes there may be a small cost associated. Great sites to access these resources include PBIS World, Centervention, and Teachers Pay Teachers. You can use basic or generic visuals with your schedule, or if it is more helpful, you can also use visuals that contain familiar people or pictures of your child engaging in the scheduled task. This helps your child associate himself with the expected task in familiar places. Depending on your situation, you may choose to create a visual schedule that is fixed and cannot be altered, or you could use Velcro so that the schedule is more fluid and flexible. The Velcro option can also serve as a sort of checklist, as well as an option for positive praise and reinforcement, such as this one. Here are some examples. So over here, this is the one that will provide praise and reinforcement. You can see this is one that can be used in the home. You can also use it in the school, but it has their list of tasks that they need to complete, as well as visuals for them. So you can either move these, or if you want your child to kind of self-monitor, they can move them once they complete them. So this says go to the bathroom, and then once he or she is done, they move that down here that it's completed, and it says super, and that's a form of praise. The next one, eat breakfast. They move it down, you rock. And you can see each one has different positive praises to reinforce your child's behavior or task. So this one was a free resource that I got off of Life Overseas. That's C'S. So you can get that for free online. Up here, this is the type a lot of our elementary teachers use or our self-contained classrooms use. And you can see that it has the time, and it actually shows it on a clock so that they can associate the time with the clock as well. And then it has the task and visuals. And I just put a few up here just for an example, but you can do them by the quarter hour, by the half hour, by the hour. This was also a free resource. And it is from thisreadingmama.com. That's thisreadingmama.com. And then this one is one you can also use in the home as kind of a checklist. So again, we can create or help that student or gain some skills where they're monitoring their own task and organizing, learning some of those executive functioning skills where they're learning to manage their daily routine. That's a very important skill we want them to learn. So I would recommend laminating this one, and you can change it as you see fit. It has visuals as well. And then they can get a dry erase marker and check it off. And then start all over the next day. So for our students that are in secondary, we can also use basic schedules. We don't have to have visuals. We could if we needed to. It can still be appropriate for those secondary students. And then again, another idea is taking pictures of your child completing these tasks and using those as your visuals so that they associate themselves with those tasks. So I hope this helps, and have a great week. I'll see you next week. Bye.